Legislative Resolution Number 4977 by Senator Hoylman, celebrating the life and accomplishments of Edith Windsor, an American LGBT rights activist and technology manager for IBM.
Senator Hoylman.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to speak about the life and accomplishments of Edie Windsor, a civil rights trailblazer and the godmother of the gay marriage movement here in New York State and across the country and indeed the world. I have brought forth a resolution that is also being considered in the New York State Assembly by my colleague Rebecca Seawright. And I'm honored that we're in the presence of LGBTQI advocates who have formed a coalition under the auspices of the advocacy groups through Gabriel Blau and others, and have come to the state capitol in hundreds to speak to legislators about a number of bills that we should be considering on the floor today in terms of advancing the LGBTQI agenda, the gay agenda. And Edie was at the forefront of that, Mr. President. Edie was born Edith Schlein in Philadelphia back in 1929. She was the youngest of three children of Jewish immigrants. And beginning in the 50s, after being a computer research assistant at NYU, she started at IBM, where she attained the highest technical rank and won a competitive IBM PhD. She was married early in her life to a man, but was jealous if she saw two women out together. After a year of being with this man, she said, quote, "Honey, this is wrong. You deserve more and I need something else." Well, Edie says they didn't talk again until her 70th birthday, but when he called her, he said, "I still love you," and that was great. Fearing exposure as a lesbian, Edie kept her sexuality secret from her employer and her work colleagues. But back in 1963, she met the first love of her life, Dr. Thea Speier, at a lesbian bar in the West Village. And back in the 60s, Edie got to witness some amazing things, including the rebellion at the Stonewall Inn in 1969. She and Dr. Speier were among the first to sign up for New York City's domestic partnership registry back in 1993, which was so important because it extended for the first time housing and health insurance and other benefits to gays, lesbians, and even unmarried heterosexuals. And finally, after living together for 40 years, and I don't know how many straight couples can say that, but we should honor all of them. Edie and Thea were legally married in Canada in 2007 by Canada's first openly gay judge. And Edie talked about how special it was to be married. She said, "Married is a magic word, and it's magic throughout the world. It has to do with our dignity as human beings to be who we are openly." Well, sadly, Thea passed away, and what ensued was an incredible injustice, because Edie applied for an estate tax exemption that any spouse would have received, something that I think this chamber talks about a lot. But the Defense of Marriage Act, which was passed back in 1996, made her ineligible for that. She was thus required to pay $363,053 in taxes to the federal government and $275,528 to New York State on her inheritance. She would later say she wouldn't have owed the government all those estate taxes if she had been married to a man named Theo rather than a woman named Thea. In stepped a good friend of mine and a constituent named Roberta Kaplan, who's one of the top lawyers at the time at a big law firm, and took on Edie's case pro bono. She represented her unsuccessfully in a marriage case here in New York in 2006 and wanted to pursue it further, all the way to the Supreme Court. But LGBT advocates at the time didn't want her to go any further. They actually refused to take Edie's case, saying it was the wrong time for the movement. Well, Robbie Kaplan took that case on, and she remembered the words of Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., who had said decades earlier that there is no wrong time to seek justice. So Roberta Kaplan, corporate lawyer, takes on Edie's case, and it goes all the way to the Supreme Court. At the heart of the case, which was called Windsor versus the United States of America, was the principle that gay people have the dignity and the Constitution mandates that this dignity be respected equally under the law. And they won that case. And since Windsor, more than 40 federal district court opinions and 4 circuit courts have held that the U.S. Constitution requires that gay people be allowed to marry. That demonstrates the remarkable clarity of the Windsor case. Now, Edie met her second wife, the second love of her life, Judith Kazin Windsor, at a Hanukkah party in 2015. I think I was at that Hanukkah party, but there is no photographic evidence. They were married on September 26, 2016, in New York City Hall. And it encapsulates one of Edie's most famous mottos in her life, which is, don't postpone joy and keep it hot. It was this relentless optimism of Edie Windsor, this belief that we can do better, that has led us here today. The belief that government should champion the rights of all people equally. Her fight, Mr. President, for equal representation under the law has changed the lives of LGBTQI Americans and people across the world. I am personally grateful for Edie Windsor's courage and determination, and I am so honored, Mr. President, to be here in the presence of Edie's widow, Judith Kazin Windsor, who I'd like to introduce, as well as the champions from Equality New York and other advocacy groups in the chamber fighting for LGBTQI rights. Mr. President, could you please recognize Judith Kazin Windsor and bestow to her all of the courtesies and privileges of this House? Thank you, Mr. President.
We certainly welcome you to the New York State Senate. Thank you for your courage and your advocacy on behalf of New Yorkers. And we extend to you the privileges and courtesies of this House. I'd ask my colleagues to please stand and recognize our distinguished guests. The question is on the resolution. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted.